Good morning and a special welcome to any visitors who are here with us today. We're certainly glad that you could be with us. We have today's Youth Mass music, and there are music sheets in the ends of the pews. Please join in singing, and if not singing, join in prayer in your heart. And our entrance hymn is Let the River Flow.
In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord with you. Thank you. Sir, let the rivers of God's graces flow into us. For times we have not responded to that river of God's grace, God's love, we ask God's forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you are the way we follow. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the truth we seek. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the life without end. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May my God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, make us life everlasting. Amen.
Oh,
And let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may always be wrapped in darkness, that we may not be wrapped in darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Kings. The Lord said to Elijah, "You shall anoint Elisha, son of Shaphat, of Abel-Meholah, as prophet to succeed you." Elijah set out and came upon Elisha, son of Shaphat, as he was plowing the 12 yoke of oxen. He was following the 12th. Elijah went over to him and threw his cloak over him. Elisha left the oxen, ran after Elijah, and said, "Please let me kiss my father and mother goodbye, and I will follow you." Elijah answered, "Go back. Have I done anything to you?" Elisha left him, and taking the yoke of oxen, slaughtered them. He used the plowing equipment for fuel to boil their flesh and gave it to his people to eat. Then Elisha left and followed Elijah as his attendant. The word of the Lord. reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, for freedom Christ set us free. So stand firm and do not submit again to the yoke of slavery. For you were called for freedom, brothers and sisters, but do not use this freedom as an opportunity for the flesh. Rather, serve one another through love. For the whole law is fulfilled in one statement, namely, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. But if you go on biting and devouring one another, beware that you are not consumed by one another. I say then, live by the Spirit, and you will certainly not gratify the desire of the flesh. For the flesh has desires against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. These are opposed to each other, so that you may not do what you want. But if you are guided by the Spirit, you are not under the law. The Word of God.
Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
When the days for Jesus being taken up were fulfilled, he resolutely determined to journey to Jerusalem, and he sent messengers ahead of him. On the way, they entered a Samaritan village to prepare for his reception there, but they would not welcome him, because the destination of his journey was Jerusalem. When the disciples, James and John, saw this, they asked, Lord, do you want us to call down fire from heaven to consume them? Jesus turned and rebuked them, and they journeyed to another village. As they were proceeding on their journey, someone said to him, I will follow you wherever you go. Jesus answered him, Foxes have dens, and birds of the sky have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to rest his head. And to another he said, Follow me. But he replied, Lord, let me go first and bury my Father. But he answered him, Let the dead bury the dead, but you go and proclaim the kingdom of God. And another said, I will follow you, Lord, but first let me say farewell to my family at home. To him Jesus said, No one who sets a hand to the plow and looks to what was left behind is fit for the kingdom of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
For the past 6 months, I've been asking all of you to pray for my sister as she recovers from cancer in the jaw. I'm glad to say she's with us today.
So thank you for your prayers. Welcome Sandy be with us today. I think one of the best commentaries on the first part of our gospel is Abraham Lincoln, probably one of the finest and most spiritual of all American presidents. It was during the Civil War, Lincoln was often criticized for not being severe enough on the soldiers of the South. In fact, one of the generals North said, "Why didn't you destroy the enemy when you had a chance?" President Lincoln answered these words adapted from today's gospel, "Do not destroy my enemy by making him my friend. Do not destroy my enemy by making him my friend." I think that's what Jesus tells us in today's gospel, to make our enemies our friends. Jesus comes to bring healing, healing of our hearts. I think all of today's readings have to do with call of commitment, being called to follow Christ, called to follow God. Elisha is a little bit hesitant at first, but then he follows. He responds to God's invitation. Now, today's response, I think, in a way, is calling us, recognize that our baptism, we're called to allow the Lord to lead us on the path of life. Are we willing to respond? Our baptism is one that calls us to follow, but it's up to us to respond to the invitation each day. Today's gospel, the second part of it, we have disciples being called, but they have excuses. Excuses of why not to respond, why not to follow. Oftentimes we can do the same thing. Lord, I can't respond, can't do it, too much, too busy, have to take care of the friends or families. You know, it was over 40 years ago, so I probably had some of the same excuses. Lord, I can't do it, I have a speech problem. I can't get up in front of people. In fact, I can't even read up in front of people. I get scared to death. Sure not calling me, Lord. And Lord, I can't sing. Remember back in 7th grade, our class is making a record. Class is pretty good. But it said to me, Dennis, just mouth the words. I couldn't carry a tune in the showers. I remember when I was in college, I thought, well, I'll take up the trombone. I said, learn some instrument to play. First day class, the professor said, after I tried to play something, he said, sing Three Blind Mice. I sang all the same note. He said, you sure you got the right instrument? The Lord will respond if we're willing to respond, if we're willing to step forward. Now, when I entered into college, I had those excuses. Lord, I'm not sure this is where you're calling me to. I can't speak very well. And so he gave me a speech teacher I had for 8 years. Every time I got together with my speech teacher, he had me sing the scales. So I at least carried tone a little bit better than I used to. Back in 78, I said yes. As challenging experiences, I tried to do jail ministry. I thought surely that'd get me out of this idea of priesthood. Did pretty well at that. Well, let me try high school retreat work. Once a semester, went and did a different high school retreat for seniors. Did pretty good at that. Okay, Lord. So I said yes. Went out to Washington, Missouri, my first assignment. My pastor's deacon said, "We're going to send you someplace, tell the board to send you someplace, where the pastor needs a lot of help." So pastor was about 66, getting ready for retirement. I was there for a couple of years. I came to the pastor and said, "You know, we are growing our school. We need to add classrooms to the multi-purpose building." He said, "No, we can't do that." And he said, "Well, yes, we can, if you take charge of it." My first building experience, fundraising. But now I have a nice multi-purpose building named after the pastor and 6 classrooms. Certainly, my response of yes, that commitment, has been a wild adventure. I never expected I would spend 6 years at the University of Missouri Columbia, Newman Center. 1,200 families, 3 colleges, meeting lots of different people, people all over the world. Then the small parish of Hillsboro, Missouri. There for 9 years, enjoyed being there, a nice small little community. Come here to St. Genevieve, oldest church in the diocese, and Valley Schools to be administrators. What an adventure. I certainly met a lot of interesting people, certainly have added to my adventure of life. Because you never know where the Lord will take you when you say yes. But willing to say yes, he will provide. He certainly has provided for me. Be able to be up here today, share with you the gospel, gospel messages. Gospel message calls us to commitment. Are we willing to say yes? Yes to what the Lord is calling us to. We don't always do it very well at times, but the good news is if we're willing to respond, he will help us along the way. I remember back in 85, their old article for Reader's Digest was about a Catholic advertising executive, very successful in her career. But sitting one day for breakfast, she was sitting with her marketing consultant. She mentioned that feeling of emptiness she had in life. And luckily, a marketing executive consultant had some wise words. He said to her, "Do you want to feel the emptiness?" "Oh, yes." "Well, spend an hour each day in prayer. Begin your day with prayer." "Oh, I can't do that. I'll go off my rocker." He said, "I tried that 20 years ago. It's been a lifesaver." So next morning, she got up, found herself spending some time in prayer. That certainly has been her lifesaver, spending time in prayer. Oftentimes, we respond to the Lord's invitation, wonder, can we do it or not? How important prayer is. Coming to church, spending time in adoration, where we find ourselves, taking time for prayer, taking time to make God important in our lives, saying yes to that commitment. If you're willing to say yes, the Lord will provide. Now, as I leave St. Genevieve, I just think about three things. I ask you to pass on, continue to pass on the message of Christ's love, Christ's mercy. And especially in this year of mercy, you can pass on the year of mercy onto others, God's love and grace. Whether it's on the football field, whether it's in the baseball field, classroom, place of work, passing on the message of Christ's love. Invite to continue to support the work, the good work here at St. Genevieve and Valley Schools. It's through your willingness to support us, whether through your time, treasure, or treasures, to know that they're very important, able to do the great things we do because of your support. And continue to work on the spirit of welcome. Father Greg and I have been working on trying to encourage people to welcome, whether it's but ushers, whether people gather here, to give a word of welcome to others. How good it is to hear people say, "Can I join your parish? I feel so welcome." It's happening. I want to thank you for your support and your prayers. For you to know that as I leave here, that you have my prayers. I ask for you to pray for me as I move on. Thank you.
And let us stand. Joining us in the Nicene Creed, I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, one Son of God, God of all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, begotten with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men, for our salvation, came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, was born of the Virgin Mary,
became the head. For our sake, he was crucified at the house of Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, according to the scriptures. He ascended to heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. Believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Lord, who proceeds from the Father
and the Son,
who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified,
who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church.
I confess
one baptism for the forgiveness of sins.
Now,
life and world to come. Amen.
At this time, kind of bring our prayers and knees to God, our Father.
For the church, that we may hear God's call to discipleship and seek first the reign of God in our lives, let us pray to the Lord. For the grace of freedom, that we may know the freedom of mind and heart so that we can serve those in need around us, and not be controlled by the expectations and demands of society. Let us pray to the Lord. For those whom God is calling to discipleship as priests and religious, that Christ may put aside any fears or worries they have in saying yes to his invitation. Let us pray to the Lord. For Father Dennis, as he says farewell this weekend to our parish family of St. Genevieve, in order to begin his new assignment in House Springs, that he may know our love and gratitude for his 7 years of generous service as pastor. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who are making life-changing decisions, that they may be aware of God's support and his spirit of courage as they enter the next chapter of their life. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who are prone to violence, that they may seek the healing they long for in God, rather than lashing out at others with their anger and resentment, let us pray to the Lord. That we may accept the hardships that the gospel entails and loosen our grasp on this world that is passing away, so that we can cling to that which eternally endures, let us pray to the Lord. For the sick and the aged, that Christ may speak words of comfort to their hearts as they face difficult times in their journey of life and faith, let us pray to the Lord. For our beloved dead and for those who die by violence each day, that the resurrection will be made known to them and consolation given to their families who miss them, let us pray to the Lord. And for all those special prayers and intentions we hold in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, we're thankful for your yes to us. I ask you to continue to encourage us and strengthen us in our yes to you, our commitments. Yes, hear and answer our prayers to Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our second collection after communion is to support the needs of the youth in the parish.
My soul is thirsty for you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God, thirsting for you, my God. Oh, God, you are my God, and I will always praise you. In the shadow of your wings, I cling to you, and you hold me high. My soul is thirsty for you, O Lord, thirsty for you, my God,
Let us stand. Brothers and sisters, let us pray that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted, God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all.
O God, graciously accomplish the effects of your mysteries. Grant, we pray, that these at which we serve you be worthy of these sacred gifts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God, for we know it belongs to your boundless glory. You came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity. You have fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself. The cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through whom the host of angels adore your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices of praise join with theirs in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim. Fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, the gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon like dewfall, become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and willing his passion, he took bread, gave thanks, broke it, gave the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you need of it, for this is my body, which is given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, took the chalice. Once more giving thanks to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant poured out for you for many forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. To celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we gather one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Robert our Bishop, all the clergy and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Genevieve, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through Christ, through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him in him, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And so, to save his command, upon the divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, I pray, from every evil. Grace, grant peace in our days. That with help and mercy, we are always free from sin and safe from all distress. As with the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, power, and glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grace, grant her peace. And unity, of course, with their will, lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Thank you.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Bless those called to supper the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to be shut under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
I'd like to take effect in the next few moments. This next song is called Strength for the Journey. And I'd like to take the next few moments as a congregation to pray for Father Dennis using this song as he continues on his journey to do the will of God. And just one thing that might be just a little bit difficult. In this song, if we could change the words, I will be your strength for the journey. I will be, or let's change that to, we will be, as we continue to pray for him as he is on his journey. So if we could say, we will be.
Thank you. Let us stand, let us pray. May this divine sacrifice, if offered and received, fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you with lasting charity, we bear fruit that lasts forever, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
And just a few announcements this morning. In your kindness, please pray for the repose of the soul of Leola Douglas of our parish. Memorial Mass is here at St. Genevieve Church on Tuesday, June 28th at 10 a.m. Also, in your kindness, Please pray for the repose of the soul of Marvin Fred Harmon, brother of Benjamin and Martin Harmon of our parish. Visitation is on Wednesday from 4 o'clock to 6 o'clock at Bosler Funeral Home, and the memorial service is at Bosler Funeral Home Wednesday at 6 o'clock. And also, immediately after Mass, there will be a reception for Father Dennis at the DeBerg Center. Please come over to show your appreciation for all Father Dennis has done for our parish.
Also, I'd like to take a moment to thank Daryl Buckeye. A few years ago, I came to Daryl and said, Daryl, you'd be interested in playing for our Mass once a month at 10:30, and him and his group has done an excellent job, so thank you. The Lord be with you. God bless us all. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our recessional hymn is Light the Fire.
Thank you.